A quick fix for this is to be much more explicit in how we want to format our dates, rather than using some intelligent default that Dimple chooses. Going back to our editor, a quick fix for this problem is to simply add a date parse format to our x-axis, in this case setting it to %Y. And while these strings might seem mysterious, it's actually an old Unix standard called strftime, and most programming languages and libraries implement it. So if you've ever worked with a date in another language, such as R or Python, this should seem familiar. What this line tells us is to parse the date on the x-axis, which corresponds to year, according to this format, %Y. %Y actually stands for a four-digit year, for example, 1966, 1970, and there's many other ways to interpret your dates, but I don't want to spend time now going over every possible way to use this strf time string. So I've left a cheat sheet in the instructor notes, and if we refresh our page now, you'll notice that as we hover over any bar, the dates are correct. In this case, 1962, in this case, 1966. One quirk of this is that they're still placed at the first of the year, in this case, January 1st, which isn't the exact date the game was at or this World Cup was held, since most of them happen in the summers. But for simplicity, let's not worry about this. And as long as we have the year, that's all we're interested in.